Hello, it's Slipper, and I'm so happy you're here because today we are back on Winter Patch, and I'm wearing my Bob the Builder outfit today. A little bit of drama happened, so we had to actually rebuild spawn. I'd rather not talk about it because it just, we are strong bunnies and strong people, and we are going to, you know, stay strong. And CC's here. Hi, CC. Hi, CC. I wanted to record because look how cool this thing is. It's for the Super Bowl, so you can either vote Falcons or vote Patriots. Okay, so open the middle chest and pick a team to vote for. Blue equals Patriots, red equals Falcons. Then name the wool your name. I don't think I have enough levels. Toss the wool over the counter on the correct side you're voting for. Thanks for participating. The winners will get a prize. Okay, cool. So I actually live in Georgia, so I am definitely for the Patriots. Why did I say Patriots? I'm definitely for the Falcons. I was against the Patriots last year. I just didn't like them. So, I mean, if you're a Patriots fan, I'm sorry, no offense, but I like the Seahawks better than them. Okay, so red. I don't think I have enough. Let's see if I have enough. I don't. No! Oh wow. I thought I was gonna die there. Lol. Oh wait, what's up here? More houses. Ooh, there's a new person. I don't remember them. Oh my goodness, there's so many new people. Oh my god. Oh wait, I can do it for you. Great. Aw, rain. Oh, she's coming. Okay. Oh, and by the way, I made the sword. I think I made it in my stream. Yeah, so if you guys saw my stream, you guys are in the know. Hey, Cakey, my queen. All hail Cakey the queen. Yeah. What's going on? Cakey! What's going on? Okay, there, now she's coming. Thank you, my queen. My bunny. Ah, thank you. Yay. Wait, what? Ender chests? Ooh, these are cool. Okay, cool. Coolio. Okay, this is my new spawn. It's a tree now. I really liked my mushroom, but I like my tree too. It's my tree. It's like my little tree house. And tree houses are magical. I'm just gonna... Ooh, I got an apple! Oh, yum! Got a nice snack there. Oh, I wish there was a little... Do I have shears? Okay, no, I don't think I do. That'd be pretty cool, though. Okay! So... That was an interesting start to the episode. There is somebody I need to introduce you guys. I have to use like ghetto doors, so I have just dirt here because I do not want her to go to spawn and die. So this is Fluffy Butt! Yay! The loveliest of bunnies in the whole entire world, the best, my bunny sister. She's my bunny sister on here. I don't know. Do we have any other like bunnies like on the server? I don't know. But my bunny sister Cece, she was so sweet and she gave this to me. So yes, we have Fluffy Butt. She is so beautiful. She's so beautiful. So now we have a total of four animals, four pets. So we have eating problem, Mr. Numbs. and Mason and Fluffy, but oh, I... Do they still have the magical button? Oh my gosh. Wait, what's that noise?
You ain't even cute. What you doing here? Get out. Get out. No, no. You ain't even cute. Yeah, that's right. You get hurt. That's right. Okay.
Do they still have a magical button? I'm curious about that. Let's go. Let's see. Let's explore. Does the magical button still exist? And if it does, I must give it a hug. Okay, remember it was like over here. I'm gonna ask, does it? Where is it? Magical button! Where's the magical button? I don't see my friend, the magical button. I have to give him a hug. Remember, you have to hug the magical button. You have to respect the magical button. I don't see it around. Magic buttons still exist. I'm gonna climb this mountain. Okay, no, I'm not. I'm gonna do it. Oh, look, it's a unicorn. Hello there, unicorn. I don't think so. No magical button. I'm just gonna climb up this mountain for no reason. The magical button does not exist anymore. Okay, let's eat some steak. Let's eat steak while we're sad because the magical button does not exist. I'm gonna jump down. Like, oh no, that might not, this might be a bad idea. But I don't, oh, there's water right there. Okay, never mind. I'll just use this water. Whee! Yeah, oh look, puppy! Sugar, oh sugar. Here, I'll give you some food. Yes, you a good little, you good little doggy. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Okay, sorry. Yes. I don't know whose doggy that is, but you have a very adorable doggy. And I hope you don't mind that I give him some steak. Oh, who's this? We got Charcoal. Interesting name. To name a bunny. Very interesting. Is that a bear? Look, it's a bear! Oh my gosh, it's a bear! Can I give him a hug? Will he read me a book? Will he read me Bearstein Bears? Oh my gosh, I remember those books growing up. Does anybody still, like, read those? As like, do the little kids still read those books? Or do they read, like, different weird stuff? Wait, what?! Who's this? It's another doggy who doesn't even have a name. I don't know if I'm feeding him. Oh, puppy. Wait, let me right click. Okay. Yeah, I think he's fed. I think the person doesn't know that they're supposed to use sticks to name them. And then from there you can... How am I gonna get over there? Oh gosh. What? Okay. We'll just do it the ghetto way. That works, right? Yeah, I think that needs to be changed. I mean, I really like this. This is pretty. But we need an easier way to get up from that area, you know, if we ever decide to, like, explore around. Okay. So, today's mission is to start building my house. Now, if you did not see my live stream, which I had, you probably didn't. Sorry. I just hate spiders with a passion in real life and in Minecraft. They are the most annoying creatures since birth. Since unsliced bread. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna kill this spider. You ain't even cute. Where are you? Get. Yeah! Yeah! What? Oh gosh. Oh. Yeah. I guess I didn't hit him. Okay. Now, there has been
an area over here that has just been spawning mobs. Like, I mean, mobs don't spawn. Well, I mean, they do spawn, but they just stay. They just stick around. And I'm so scared to just walk around. Simply just walk around. Oh, get out of here. I don't like you. You're cute. You're really cute. What? Get out of here. You ugly. Ooh, give me those slime balls. Oh, yeah. I will make some leads happily with your life, with your dead bodies. It's kind of sad. You were kind of cute before, but I didn't like you enough to keep you alive. So, wonder if there's mobs over there, like, right now. Like, I don't know, like, what's the deal with it? But, like, I was blown up by a creeper in this one area. And it's like, I'm so scared to just walk over here. Which, by the way, that cave over there is just ugly. And I'm gonna have to, like, cover it up. Oh, my child. My child. No. My sister child mother. Bunny sister mother child. I don't know. I don't know our relationship. Okay, I'm not dead yet. Okay, so this is the beginning of my house. It's just kind of the base of my house. It's just gonna be two stories. It's gonna be two stories high. And there are horses. There's a horse over there, which I really want to craft a saddle. Because that would be so cool. I don't know why I haven't done that. You know what? Let's do that. Oh, look! We need to name them. Is there a way? Is there a possibility to tame these guys? I don't think there is, but we should name them. I think your name should be. I don't Feisty butt. Feisty butt. Scary butt. Okay, fluffy butt. If you jump out, I will be so mad at you. Okay, she didn't. Okay, good job. Mason, here, have a pork chop. It's not even a pork chop, but you can eat that. Yeah, so we're gonna take our leather. Yeah, and then we need three pieces of iron. Okay, I don't know how you do this. I don't know if you can just, you know, like ride them and like tame them, kind of like Minecraft horses. Okay, let's do it. Let's go on an adventure. Oh wait, let me put on some armor though. It's not. It's about to die. The armor is about to die. But we can. Oh, look at the baby deer! Oh my gosh, you're so cute. Wait, what's up right there? Oh. Do you have indigestion or something? Like, do you need some Tums or something? I think that's what people normally eat when they have indigestion. Ooh! What did I hear? I heard something spooky and I didn't like it. It was, oh, I think that was just me walking on sand. It was spooky and I didn't like it. I don't like it. No spooky sand walking. Okay, let's see if we can get over there. I'm scared to go through those trees because I feel like something's just gonna sneak up on me like a creeper or something. It's just gonna blow me up. Oh, look at this! Pig pet. Yeah. Coolio. Yeah. Woo! Jump. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Just jump. Just jump. I don't even have a shovel. Look at my inventory. It's so ridiculous. I'm sorry, guys. I'm an embarrassment. Look how pretty this little. They're zebras. There's zebras. Little birdie. Oh, I thought I saw a snake. Okay, I was like, look at the. Oh my goodness. What's over here? What else is over here? Is there any other magical creatures? Is there any other? Oh, there's more horses. There's more birds. I love a birdie. I love you so much.
You're like a little cardinal. I love birds so much. What's that? Oh, it's a goat. Okay, I was like, oh my gosh! It's the most magical creature in the whole entire universe. A goat. Just kidding. Goats aren't that great. I mean, they're great, don't get me wrong, but. Oh, it's a little cricket. Hello there, cricket. How you doing? Okay, are you like a pony? What? How do. Do I have to like. Ooh! Okay, this is like. Oh, wow. Okay. I don't even know what to name you! I feel like honey. Like honeycomb. Honeycomb. Honeycomb! Oh my goodness! Honeycomb! Up here, come on, honeycomb, you can do it! Oh, I'm scared to come down here. Oh no, honeycomb! You can't die! You need to, like, stay. Stay. No, honeycomb! There is a snake! Wait! Oh, get it! Okay. That was anticlimactic. Come on! Honeycomb, no! You can't do this to me! Come on, stay! 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 Come on! You gotta. Honey. I'm gonna kill Honeycomb! Oh no! Okay. I think I should log off. Oh wait! Do I have my. Oh, I do. Did it work? Yes, it worked. Come on, honeycomb. Let's go home. No! Honeycomb. Oh, okay. Honeycomb. Oh, you scared me, honeycomb. You can do it. I believe in you, honeycomb. Swim. Swim, my majestic, laggy steed. Okay, no, you're not going the right way. This way. My child, this way. Yeah, good job. Okay, oh my gosh. Honeycomb, kill it! Okay, just go. Just. Oh, I don't like it. No! Ugh, I hate that noise. Bugs ain't cute. Get out of the way! Leave. What you doing? Leave me alone! Make a light at you. Oh, I don't like that bug. No, buggy. No, buggy. Get out of here. You're bugging me. All the puns for me today. Yay, look, she made a sound. She made a sound of delight about seeing our house. Clearly she's home. Hang out here. Money, honey, honey, honey. I hope you can't jump out of here, because that would be really annoying. What are you doing? Get out of here! Can you jump out of here? Okay, I wanna look. You jump out. Because I don't want you just wandering around. I want you to stay. Stay with me. Because you're all I need. Wait. Okay, let's see. Let's just watch him. Okay, I'm not sure, but I don't really think that he can escape. Oh, honeycomb, I love you. You're so laggy, but I love you, my child. You're my child. Honeycomb, we have so many pets. It's so great. We got a bunny, we got a puppy, we got two goats, and a horsey. Yay! Honeycomb. He looks like he's on fire, but that's just the torch. Okay. Yeah, that was just the torch. Yay! Let's breed our chickadees. Aw, you guys are so cute. Okay. Make a little baby. Aw, they're in love. Oh, you're the mama. Let me see your baby. Oh, so cute. He has your eyes and your feathers and his beak. Oh, how sweet. Oh, okay. Okay, it appears that Honeycomb cannot escape. We should probably make a stable for Honeycomb. And I might also have, like, other horses. Because there was a lot of horses over there, so. No, no, Fluffy Butt, you ain't be escaping. Look at this, guys. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Look at this. Oh my gosh. He's just following me around. He left. Aw. I have my texture pack on now. Yay. Look at Honeycomb. And then, of course, that's Fluffy Butt. You can't jump up, right? I got my eye on you. She just jumped away. Okay, I'm scared to walk around because I feel like I'm gonna die. But what's that? Okay. That's not that scary. Okay. I want to tame a raccoon. I found out that you can tame raccoons, and I really want to tame a raccoon. I really want a big cat, too, but I don't think that's going to happen because I don't see any, like, babies. Like, you can only tame a baby. A baby big cat. There's my house! It's looking really cute! Man, this grass is taking forever to grow. I want it to eventually, you know, of course, grow up here. Look at that majestic zebra. I definitely need to get a zebra. I definitely need to make a stable. That has to be done. Okay, we even got some modern art in our view. Like, look at that modern art. But I love those trees so much. They're so pretty. I don't like those vines. I think those vines are really ugly. But, and like, this mountain right here is pretty ugly too. But I'll live with it. Like, maybe we could, like, put, like, a waterfall or something. And maybe we could try to get rid of some of these, like, ugly vines. Because they're just everywhere. They're just too much. They're just, oh. Oops. They're just a little too intense, in my opinion. I just don't like them. So we are going to start, well, I'm going to start working on the shape. Like, I think I'm gonna make these rooms, like give them a little bit more shape to them, and then I think I'm just basically just gonna you know, make the walls and then make a second floor, and then I'm gonna make the roof and stuff, and it's gonna be castle-y. Oh, it's about, okay, I know exactly what to do. I really want to spawn him. You snake and you right click. How come it didn't work? Sneak and right click. Sneak and right click. What? What? No, that's sad. I wanted to spawn him. Yay, I spawned him. Yay, look at him. He's going to be my little buddy. Okay. I wish it would stop raining. Okay, well, we are gonna start building with my little buddy. He needs a name. What his name should be, but he needs a name. Bed Pet! Where'd you? Oh, there you are. Like, what? I swear, I am hearing a dog. No, Bed Pet! Ah, no! Come up here! Teleport! Can you teleport? Drown, right? Like, he's just a bed. Like, Bed Pet! No! Okay, guys, pray for Bed Pet that he doesn't die. Oh, wait, he left. Okay. Well, he's about to leave. Wait, yep, he's gone. He's gone now. He's safe and sound in my hand now. So don't worry, guys. Okay. Starting now! Building!
Hey guys, it is Slipper here, and I'm just doing a voiceover for the building because I thought a story would be a nice thing to listen to while you enjoy some speed building. Because sometimes just simply listening to music and watching these can get a little bit boring. But anyways, I wanted to talk about the story I wanted to share the story that recently happened, which was I got to go to Winter Jam. And I wanted to tell this story in this episode because Winter Jam, Winter Patch, ha ha ha. Okay, anyways, they have very similar names. So if you're not familiar with Winter Jam, it is this amazing concert where it's $10 and it's a bunch of different artists and it's just crazy, but it is a Christian concert. So it's just, you know, all Christian artists, but it's a variety of music. So there's like, you know, there's rap music, there's, you know, rock music, there's like intense rock music. A few years ago, Red, oh my gosh, they were insane. They like literally had fire. They had fire on stage and it was like, they were just scary. And I was just like, I don't know. I can't get into that kind of music. It's not really my kind of music. but anyways, yeah. So there's like a variety of music and it's a lot of fun. And this year, like some of the artists that were there were like, let me think, what was his name? They had like 10th Avenue North and David Crowder. They had Britt Nicole and like, they had like one of these, they had a rapper guy. He was really fun. Like Andy Mineo or something. Mineo. Yeah. So it was just a lot of fun. So I went with my youth group to this event and it was just craziness because we left at like 12 and the event starts, the doors open at 5 and the event officially starts at 6. And like Atlanta is only like about maybe 30 minutes away, like maybe like 40 minutes away. I don't know. It's not that long of a ride over there. Like, it's not crazy. Like, we had to get there super duper early. And even though, like, there's always, like, a ton of people, this year was in the Georgia Dome. So there was, like, plenty of space. Because the last time we went, it was in the Phillips Arena. And the Phillips Arena is a lot smaller than the Georgia Dome. So, like, I was thinking it was a little bit ridiculous that we were leaving so early. Like, I mean, Winter Jam gets a lot of people, but it's not going to completely fill the dome. And there was plenty of space. Like, there was probably enough space for a few thousand people. We would be very snug, and it would be, like, you know, a little snug, but, like, there was plenty of space. Yeah. but anyway, so we left at like 12, and like in our van, for some reason, I don't know why, don't ask me why, but my youth pastor had there was a like mannequin in the back seat, and it was just terrifying. It was just, her name is Gertie, and she had like this wig on, these like purple wig on, and she was just like collapsed like in the back seat, and it was just terrifying, just creepy looking, and I'm just like, why? But that's just, it's like stuff like that is just normal, I guess, to, you know, typical youth groups, because youth groups get crazy. yeah, so that was weird. But so we leave and we get there, we had to like, we like parked at this place and we walked like a long way to get to the Georgia Dome, and we didn't even like wait in, like we didn't even get in line. When we got there, we just decided that we were just going to hang out a little bit. So we just kind of just sit in this building that's like by the line. And we just kind of hang out for a while, for a long time. It just, I don't know why, but it just went by so fast. And we just kind of hung out. And eventually, like, we went to get snacks, like, at vending machines. And, like, one of the girls previously, like, just went around and just kind of explored the building. And we just went around places that we probably didn't need to be, just like, I don't know, just around the building, like places where there was just nobody else, and just like places like meeting rooms and like behind meeting rooms and like all these like weird hallways and stuff. It was fun just to be like, oh yeah, we're not supposed to be here. Well, I mean, it's not like a big deal or anything, but like, they probably didn't intend for a bunch of people just to be walking around in random places. But it was just like, Oh yeah, look at us. We're just walking around here, owning the place. But yeah, that was interesting. So then eventually we do decide to get in line. I tried to meet my friend there, but it was just, I should have just asked her like what gate she was at and like where she was at. But I didn't. I don't know why, but I didn't think about that. But she was kind of far away. I really just didn't want to walk too far away from the group. So I tried to, but it just, I don't know. It probably just would have been better for us to just enjoy our days, like our nights. Just like, it was just too much of a hassle to try to meet up. So, yeah, maybe in the future we'll be able to get to meet up together. But yeah, so we get into the building. And we didn't really get, like, I don't know, we didn't really get that great of seats. We could have if we wanted to, but I really honestly didn't want to be that close to the stage because it's, like, so loud. And I'm just glad that, I liked our seats. Like, our seats were pretty far away, but it was a good distance because we were close to the bathrooms and the food and, like, it was nice. And so then I just got myself a pretzel. Like, I didn't even really eat, like, any real food. I just, got a pretzel because, like, earlier in line, we just, like, my youth pastor, he was so nice. And he got us, like, all some sodas and candy. And I'm just, like, it was so nice. And so I pretty much just ate, like, the whole time I was there. I pretty much just, like, ate for dinner, quote, unquote, for dinner. I pretty much just ate Cheez-Its. And Skittles, M&M's, and a soft pretzel. That was pretty much it. because I don't know why, but I just wasn't that hungry. So the event was totally great. I think my favorite artist would have to be David Crowder and Ted Avenue North, which those were kind of later in the show, but I was really sad because I was really disappointed because like one of the artists was just terrible. Like Brit Nicole, she just did not do a good job. Like, I mean, I'm sorry if you liked her performance, but she just didn't. She was just very flashy, and she just, I don't know. She just, like, her dance moves and everything were just like, girl, you need to chill a little bit. She just didn't do a good, like, I was sad because I grew up listening to her, and she definitely inspired me when I was younger, like in middle school and stuff. And I did like her new song, Through Your Eyes, but I was just disappointed in her, like her show. It wasn't very good. But some of like the first artists that we listened to were like the rapper guy, the rapper guy, that's what I call it. I'm too white to listen to rap, but his name was like Andy Man. Minio or something, but he was actually really fun. I don't think I would listen to his rap, but he was really fun. Yeah, and of course you can't forget 20, what was there called, 1,000 Foot Crutch, the rock, that intense rock band. The whole time we were just like just rocking out, well, at least we were pretending to, we're just pretending to like rock it out, and just it was fun. I don't think any of us were legitly into that kind of music. It was just, like, too intense for us. But there was one of my friends who actually did like their music. But, I mean, she wasn't a part of our group, but she actually did go to the event. I didn't see her there. Like, it was, like, it's nearly impossible to see people there. Because there was a lot of people I knew that went to the event. Did I see them there? No, because it's such a huge event. So, that was some of the highlights. We got there, and there were some of the smaller bands. Oh, yeah, Sarah Reeves. It started off like Sarah Reeves. She was good. Who was, like, the first person? I don't know. I feel like Sarah Reeves was one of the first. She was really good. She was, like, some of the opening acts. I guess that's probably what they would consider her, because she didn't really have, like, that big of a show, because, like, people were still crowding in. So, I'm sorry. I'm getting out of order. But, like, yeah, so she started off with some of the smaller bands, and then they did 1,000 Foot Crutch, and then they did, like, the rapper guy. Like, I'm not doing it completely in order, because there were some bands. Oh, yeah, that's right, they had a new song there, which they're an older band, but, and the lead singer looks like Jack Black with glasses, but their music was good. I guess were they after the rapper guy? I don't know what order it was in, but that was, they had, like, new song, they had, who else did they have? I don't really remember. Oh, that's right. Colton Dixon? He has terrible hair, but he's a pretty good artist. I thought he was pretty good, but I liked 10th Avenue North. Like, that was just one of the best. He was just great. Oh, well, I know what to say. While we were in line, Jamie Grace, she just, like, walked by. She says, I love her so much. Like, I just wanted her to just, like, steal the mic from one of the artists, like, who just weren't that good, and just sing her music, because I'd rather have her than Brit Nicole. Just honestly, Brit Nicole did it. She was just sad. Like, some of her parts were fun, like, when she sang some of her older songs, but she didn't even have, like, the words up on the screen or anything, and she was, like, the one of the only artists who did that. Like, all the other artists, I mean, I'm not sure if all of them did, but most of them, I don't think the rapper guy did, but most of them had their lyrics on the screen, where you can, you know, sing along. If I was an artist, personally, I would do that, because that's, like, the worst thing ever, is, like, when you go to a show, but you just, like, don't know, like, one or, like, two songs, so you're just awkwardly just trying to, like, dance, like, just listen to the music, but, like, you wish you could sing along, because, like, that's, like, the whole thing about, like, going to concerts, is, like, you know, enjoying the music and singing along with it, and, like, I feel like, I mean, that's what I like to do when I go to a concert. Like, I haven't been to that many, but, like, I've been to 3 in total. I'm pretty sure just 3. Because I went to Winter Jam last time, which Winter Jam last time was really good. They had Toby Mac and JB Grace, and I don't know some of the other ones, but the last time I went, that's kind of the artist that they had. I was so upset that I missed, like, last year, though, because they had For King and Country, and I love For King and Country so much. They're the best. But yeah, what was I saying? I was talking about. But yeah, it was really good. The whole event was really good. David Crowder was at the very end, and he was the best. His music is the best. It just, his music, like, his lyrics and stuff, they just really just, they grab your heart, and they just, like, give you a nice heart hug. Like, if that makes sense. Like, they're really good lyrics, and I just cried during one of them, because it was just my song. Like, I just went through a lot, and that was just the song that I listened to when I was happy. And, like, after I stopped listening to that song, I remember, a long time after that, like, I started going through a lot of just trials. And then I just remember listening to it, and I was just crying, because it was just, those words really, they really meant a lot to me. And I'm getting emotional. But I cried a lot during that concert. I mean, I think I cried, like, 2 times, like, during during Offering, I cried a little bit, and then definitely when he was singing Come As You Are, because that song is just, I love that song so much, and it's just so sweet. But all of his, I love David Crowder so much, he's the best. But some of the other artists, like, at the very end, some of the other artists, they, like, came out, and they sang, I don't remember what song it was. Oh, wait, was it, like, I forgot the name of it, but it goes, like, He Loves Us, How He Loves Us. I'm pretty sure that's the name of the song. I'm pretty sure that was the song that they were singing all together. I don't remember. I think so, but I know that he sang How He Loves Us, and that song is so good, too. Oh, that song is so sweet. Oh, I love it. It just brings back so many memories. And I remember, like, in ballet, we did, like, a little dance to it, and it was so fun, because it was just kind of freestyle, so you just kind of, like, they told us, like, just to kind of listen to, like, what he's describing, and just kind of try to interpret it in, like, you know, your dance, through your dancing, and I don't know, that was just really fun. So then, after the, like, after all of it, oh, yeah, like, one thing I really liked about 10th Avenue North is that he, like, went into the crowd, and he did a lot. So did the rapper. So did Andy. He went in the crowd a lot. And Andy had a skateboard. I was just like, dude, you're so cool. But 10th Avenue North, he kept on, like, going out into the crowd. I was just like, yay. Like, I love it when, like, artists do that. I feel like that's just, it's really cool, because, like, to, like, kind of, in a way, crowd surf a little bit, but not like, not actually, but, like, to go out and to, like, sing into the crowd, I just think that's cool. But anyways, back on subject. So after the end of the show, like, we just kind of left, like, as soon as they were just kind of finished with, like, Well, they didn't, we didn't even, we left before they were completely finished. We just, like, got out of there because we know that, if you leave, if you leave when the show exactly ends, you're not going to get out of there. Like, it's going to take you forever because everyone's crowding up and there's, like, thousands of people. So, we just, like, run out. We literally run out. And then my our youth pastor, he said that he found a shortcut because when we got to the building, we had to, like, walk this long way. But he found this shortcut. It was pretty dangerous, but turns out later on we found out that, like, other youth groups were using it. But it was kind of dangerous because it's an actual road, like, an actual place, like, people can drive. So there wasn't any walkway or anything. It was just a road. And we're just, like, so we just decided to just run down it. Like, I don't know why we did, but everybody just started running. I guess because they were scared. So I was just like, I'm going to run too. I regret that decision though. And like my feet, like since it was like it was a kind of a ramp. So it was going downwards. And like I couldn't control my feet. I couldn't stop my feet. Like they were just running on their own. And I was just like, ah, this is scary. And yeah, I regret that decision because I was just like out of breath. And I was just like, I'm going to die. I don't do cardio. I don't run. But yeah, so after we ran down, we got into our bus. And then a lot of the kids were still hungry. Because we didn't really eat that much because the food was so expensive. Like, the food's always expensive, like, at concerts and stuff. And especially, like, in, like, sports arenas, like, the Georgia Dome. Oh, yeah, that's one thing that was funny is, like, one of the artists' new song, they sang the song Arise, My Love. And I was just like, yeah, rise up. Because the Falcons, even though we lost. I was so upset that we lost. I was so upset. Like, I'm sorry if you like the Patriots. But they have been known for cheating. Cheating! And I would not doubt that in my mind that they cheated. Like, honestly. Because how can you, like, come back that much? That is not the only time that they have done something like that. Where they were losing. And then they had this amazing comeback. Sure, yeah. I don't know about that. Like, I get it. Like, we got... The Falcons got a little bit too comfortable. They were like, oh, yeah, we're going to win this. So they didn't play as good, like, the second half. But then they were like, oh, crap. Like, oh, no, they're taking my ball, mommy. And we just, yeah. It is understandable because, like, you get that far and you just want it more than anything. And then somebody's trying to take it from you and just like, no. Oh, no, mommy, you took my ball. But, yeah, I was still upset about that, though. Like, I can't believe it. Like, we got so close, though. We did a good job, though. We got really close, and even though we didn't win, the fact that we got to the Super Bowl is amazing to me. That's a miracle. I just hope that the Patriots just next time, like, I hope next time, like, if we ever do get back to the Super Bowl, that it's not versus the Patriots, because I don't know if I trust them Patriots, honestly. Like, more like, Patriots! Oh! Yeah. Anyways. Sorry. I'm bad at, like, getting off subject. But so some of the kids were hungry, so we decided that we were going to go to eat. So we go to like this really ghetto part of town, and we go to this chicken sausage place. And I was so upset because I wasn't that hungry, but I just didn't want to like eat something greasy and like, you know, like I didn't want to eat that late. It was like 12. Like it was about 11. Well, was it about 11? Maybe it was about 12. Yeah, it was 12. I think it was about 12 when we were getting, like, when we were heading back. So, it was about 11 when we got there. I just got a sweet tea. That's all I got. But, like, this place looked, oh my gosh, it looked so good. Like, they had, like, all of these, it just looked really good. And it was a really nice place, like, inside. Like, even though it was a sketchy part of town, it was a nice place. It was really small, but it was a nice place. So I just got sweet tea, and other people just got, like, really good-looking food. And I was just, like, sad, but I'm like, nope, I'm not gonna go through that pain. So, because I just don't do good when I eat food late at night. So, we get our food, we head on our way. My youth pastor says that he's gonna... Since I live, like, on the way to the church, he decided that he was gonna meet up with my parents and another girl's parents, like, at this restaurant. Well, the restaurant was closed because it was, like, 12, but we meet up, and then my dad takes me home, and my brother was there, too, and, yeah, It was a lot of fun. I'm so glad that I went. And I was debating at first if I was going to go because I did invite some of my friends to go with me and none of them could. And I was a little bummed about that because it's like, you know, it would be nice to have somebody to go with that was, you know, a friend, a buddy, a pal, amigo. But it worked out good. We did have a good time. We all had a good time. And yeah, so that was my long winter jam story. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this story. Let me know if you guys want to hear more stories / ranting. It was a little bit less of a story and more like a mush of just information and just talking about stuff that's kind of a story, but like it was just all in pieces. Like, I'm sorry, I'm bad at telling stories, but if you like this, if you like hearing a story, then I would appreciate if you would let me know in a comment if you enjoyed the story. But anyways, yeah, enjoy the rest of the video. Bye!
Okay, guys, I have finished. Just kidding, I haven't finished. But I have finished for now, at least. I got stuck because I don't have any more of that green block, so I need to go mining to get that. In the next episode, I will show off the finished, my finished house! And yes, I'm really excited. I think the hardest part will probably have to be the cloud. I'm not sure if you guys want to see me building the cloud as well. If you guys want to, I can do that if you guys want me to. But I think, you know, or if you just want to see like the rest of me building, I can do that for you guys. But I think I'm just gonna, you know, go mining, see if I can find some of those green stones. Wait, let's see if I can. Those green stones. Wait. Those right there. That one right there. Yeah. So I'm gonna go mining off camera and see if I can find some more of those. If not, I might like ask around to like trade or something to get them. I just need enough to like go around the rest of the building, so yeah, and it looks like I need to adjust a few things. But of course it's not, you know, it's probably about halfway done. At least the building side of it. The cloud part, of course, there's just nothing to it. But there's no cloud yet. I'm not really sure how difficult it will be to make the cloud, but it'll be just be a matter of figuring out the shape of like the yard that will be around, and then also like kind of creating like a cloud looking shape within the yard, so it could be kind of like that, what I'm already kind of doing. Like, I think that's kind of what it's gonna look like. This, I think I'm gonna keep this, but I think I'm gonna change the shape of it to be prettier because it's kind of just ugly. maybe like, I don't really know, but I think I'm gonna keep this. What is this? Is this like marble? Yep, I knew it. See, guys, I am just, you know, a pro. But yeah, I hope you guys like the way that it's starting to look. I think it looks really cool. I definitely am excited. I know you guys, I know that Reagan, my friend, she told me that she wanted it to be like, she suggested that it be like a balcony, but I think don't, like a balcony, the second floor was just a balcony and not like a complete second floor. But I want it to be a complete second floor. There just won't be these. These won't be different rooms. These will just continue on. So that way, when you stand in here, you'll see like all of the colors. And then you'll see the top. It'll just be really cool looking. But in this, it's a little bit, I don't know. It's not as, it's a little bit comfy. But I don't think that's a problem. Anyways, I hope you guys liked the way it turned out, because I love it. Oh, why you? Okay. I love it. It's just turning out really great, you know? So, yeah, I hope you guys liked the
idea of it. It's kind of supposed to be like castle-y. That's like gonna be the finished product. So it's gonna be like 10 blocks high because I got 10 of these different colors. I think I do. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah, and then 10 with the green. I'm pretty sure it's 10, yeah. If not, then that's not that big of a deal. But look at it. It's looking so magical and like ombre, like rainbow ombre. I love it. I love it so much. Yes. Yay. I'm sad though that I ran out of green. But anyways, in the next episode, I am going to finish building. In the next episode, I'm just really excited for you guys to see the finished product, and I'm excited to see how it all turns out in the end, of course, myself. But yeah, so I hope you guys are excited to see the finish, my finished home. Yes, yay! Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you're excited to see the next episode of Winter Patch and to see my finished house. If you like this video, give a care to that like button, and if you want to see more epic content like this, then slay that subscribe button, and of course, slay the day. Bob the Builder out. Woo! I mean, slipping out. Slipper the Builder, can she fix it? Slipper the Builder, yes she can! Slipper the Builder, can she fix it? Slipper the Builder, yes she can! Woo! Bye guys! Yeah!